Welcome back to Tableau Tutorials. In this video, we are going to see that how can we first use multiple values in the columns. Up till now, we were using the dual axis option, that is this kind of a graph. But in this video, we will see how can we use that with the concept of hierarchies and group the data together in the line format or the x-axis, right? And after we have covered that, we would be seeing how can we do the same thing. That is, instead of the dual axis, we can get a triple or quadruple axis. That is whatever we want, right? So this is a new sheet that I had created in the previous video. Let me just rename it as hierarchies so that we know that we are working with hierarchies in this particular one. This is the order date kind of a column. Now in order date, what happens is the hierarchies are automatically created because we know there's going to be year, there's then going to be quarters, then months, then individual days, right? So this is a hierarchy that's already been created. So what you can do is just expand this, and now what happens is, first of all, year is written. So you see on the top, the years are written: 2018, 2019, 2020 and 2021. The second thing is the quarters. So then the quarters are written, that is Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. These all for 2018. These all for 2019. These all for 2020 and these all for 2021. Okay. If we expand it further, then we get the months, the individual months. That means this is the whole data for 2018. Let me just go to entire view. So here what we are getting is all the months from January till December, January till March for quarter 1, April till June for quarter 2, July till September for quarter 3, and October till December for quarter 4 of the year 2018. Similarly for 2019, similarly for 2020, and similarly for 2021. Furthermore, there is again plus sign. If we just further expand it, then we are getting it for individual days. So that is for 31 days of January, 28 days for February, and so on. That's for the individual days. But now you see the hierarchy cannot be broken down further because day has no symbol present in it. So this is how you can work with hierarchies. Now what happens if I want some data, like I want the sales data. Let me drag it into the rows. So this is the kind of the data that I'm getting. Of course, it's too congested. So what I'm going to do is just remove the months option and actually just work with the quarters option because that's clear. Okay, so this is the sales values that I'm getting. That is, this was the sales in the year 2018, in 2019, 2020 and 2021. Now the grouping that has occurred is that quarter 1, quarter 2, quarter 3 and quarter 4, and the year is being shown there. So whatever the dual axis concept we saw over there with the help of the y axis, it's now been shown on the line that is on the x axis. Okay. Now one thing more, if you see, they're all discontinued or discontinuous actually. So what happens is, this date is the only field in Tableau that could toggle between discrete and continuous, right? All the other fields, as we have already seen, are either purely continuous like these numeric values, or purely discrete like these category, subcategory, shipment mode, states, etc. But date is the only thing that could exist as continuous as well as discrete. Right now, if you take a look at this, it is blue in color. That means it is a discrete value. However, if you want to change it to a continuous value, how can we do that? So what we need to do is just right click over here, and you see right now discrete is being selected. If you just select continuous, so year has changed into a continuous value, but quarter is still a discrete value. So what we can do is just right click on the quarter and also make it as a continuous value, right? So it's kind of looking like messy up, because for this what we need to do is create a dual axis for this. That's not the dual axis part. What we actually need to do is just remove this year from here. Now only the quarters are visible, right? So this is the distinct quarters that we are getting. Furthermore, the values we are getting is quarter 1. So that means this quarter 1 is showing us all the values from 2018 till 2021. We don't want that. So for this, what we can do is change it to continuous, or you can just choose the second form. Like you see, there is this first group: year, quarter, month, day and more. This is for the discrete values. This is for the continuous values. In these grayed out sections, the format in which it would be changed is written. So I want the quarter as well as the year. So now if I do that, this is 2018 quarter 1, 2018 quarter 2, and so on like this. The graph is being shown in a continuous format that we wanted. Okay. So that's how you can just change the values into continuous. If you just expand it further, you see now we are not getting different kind of pills, right? We are just getting the simple one pill. Now we are getting the data for individual months of the particular year. If you further expand it, this is for the individual weeks, and this is for the individual days that we are getting. Okay, you can just delete that and bring in this order date. So if you just change this year into continuous, so nothing would change actually, but if you just want, you can just see the difference in the quarters or the months, etc. But when we change it into the continuous values, then that kind of a distinction that we were talking about won't be seen. So for that, you have to convert it back into discrete. So you can just select discrete and select the quarter and the month. So that's how it's been shown. Actually, not this kind of a discrete. You have to select this. Okay. Suppose we have selected year. Now it would be discreted like this. Okay. Perfect. Now let us talk about the concept of the dual axis. That is, how can we work with multiple axes. So let's just rename it to more than two axes. Okay, that's what we are going to see. So let me just drag subcategory. Okay, I have three quantities that I can just see: subcategory wise sales, subcategory wise profit. Let me just change this profit into a line for a better understanding, and the subcategory wise quantity. Okay, what I can do is change this quantity into automatic. Okay, automatically it's taking as a bar, so let me just change it to the circles. Okay, now what happens is, if I want to work with two, I can just right click and combine them into a dual axis. So the profit and the sales are combined, right? This is what we are getting. Let's just change sales to bar for a better understanding. But this quantity is being taken separately, right? It's not taken into the axis. So if you just right click, there is no option of dual axis, right? So how do we do that? What we can do is just remove all these three points, just drop these three, and there is this something called measure names. Now this is present in the discrete values. Okay, you have to just drag and drop it over here, right click and go to filters. Now you see all these values, that was the continuous values, are present. What you need to do is, you need to just select those values that you want to be shown. Like, I want discount to be shown, I want profit, and I want sales to be shown. Click on OK, and that should have been worked. Yeah, just a second. I want discount, profit, and sales. Click on OK. All right. So once you've done this, once you have applied the filter, the next step is that you see this measure values. You have to just drag it into the rows. Once you do that, everything is present in front of you, right? This yellow line represents the sales, red line represents the profit, and orange represents the discount. Although you cannot change individually, but you can change them in a combined format. So whatever you want, like the area chart, or these squares to be shown, or these particular shapes to be shown, you can just select them right this. Okay, but line is the best way. All you can do is change the colors. Like, you can go to the edit colors option for the sales. Suppose let's just go with green. For profit, let's just go with purple. For discount, let's just go with this kind of a color, whatever it is. So this is how it's gonna look. And let me just select this entire view. Okay, and this is the legend that is telling us about all these things. You want the labels part, you can just click on this labels, and all these individual labels are now there. That means this tells you the sales values, this tells you the profit value, and this tells you the discount values. Okay, so this is how you can work with more than two axes. Actually, if you want not three but four, what you can do is right click, go to edit filter. I also want quantity. select quantity, click on apply, click on OK. Now we have got another line, this red colored line of quantity. As you can see, this is the red colored line of quantity over here. Okay, what I just did there, I will explain in the next video.